In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld His glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by Him, and the world knew Him not. He came unto His own, and His own received Him not. But as many that received Him, to them He gave power to become the sons of God, even to them that believeth on His name. Darkness and void envelop us. We are lost in a strange span that knows no time or distance. We are back in time, before the time of creation, before the birth of the universe and man. Light has not yet entered this domain, and we drift aimlessly as though blinded by the darkness that consumes us. But God, in His infinite wisdom, has a miraculous plan. He has a purpose for what He is about to set into motion, and the Spirit of God speaks. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw that the light was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. And God called the light day. And the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning were the first day. There be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters. And God made the firmament, and divided the waters from the waters which are under the firmament from the waters above the firmament. And it was so. And God called the firmament heaven, and the evening and the morning were the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the heaven be gathered together unto one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. And God called the dry land earth, and the gathering of the waters he called seas. And God saw that it was good. And God said, "Let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed, and the fruit tree yielding fruit after his kind, whose seed is in itself upon the earth." And it was so. And the earth brought forth grass, and herb yielding seed, and the fruit tree yielding fruit after his kind, whose seed is in itself after his kind. And God saw that it was good. And the evening and the morning were the third day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night, and to let them be for signs and seasons and for days and years, and let them be for lights in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth." And it was so. And God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also, and God set them in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth, and to rule over the day and the night, and to divide the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. And the evening and the morning were the fourth day. And God said, "Let the waters bring forth abundantly the moving creature that hath life, and fowl that may fly above the earth in the open firmament of heaven." And God created great whales, and every living creature that moveth, which the waters brought forth abundantly after their kind. and every winged fowl after his kind. And God saw that it was good. And God blessed them, saying, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters and the seas, and let fowl multiply in the earth." And the evening and the morning were the fifth day. And God said, "Let the earth bring forth the living creature after his kind, cattle and creeping thing and beast of the earth after his kind." And it was so. And God made the beast of the earth after his kind, and cattle after their kind, and everything that creepeth upon the earth after his kind. And God saw that it was good. And God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth." So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. And God blessed them and said unto them, "Be fruitful and multiply, and replenish the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea and the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth." And God said, "Behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree at which there is the fruit of a tree yielding seed, to you it shall be for meat. And to every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the air, and to everything that creepeth upon the earth wherein there is life, I have given every green herb for meat." And it was so. And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. And the evening and the morning were the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the host of them. And on the seventh day, God ended his work which he had made, and he rested on the seventh day from all his work which he had made. And God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it, because that in it he had rested from all his work which God created and made. That is the account of God's creation. It is the truth at the beginning of all things. Man has searched for centuries for answers as to how the universe and life itself began. Man has developed his own theories, his own evolution of things. Scientists present theory as fact, that creation happened by chance, and that over billions of years, this process evolved on its own. One link adding on to the next, one species evolving into another species. But that theory is an errant account that is without God. The Word of God says, "These are the generations of the heavens and of the earth when they were created. In the day that the Lord God made the earth and the heavens, and every plant of the field before it was in the earth, and every herb of the field before it grew. For the Lord God had not caused it to rain upon the earth, and there was not a man to till the ground. But there went up a mist from the earth, and watered the whole face of the ground. And the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. And man became a living soul." Since the time of Adam, man has chosen his own means and by his arrogance has separated himself from God. It began in the Garden of Eden, in the perfection of God's earthly paradise, when the first man, Adam, and his wife, Eve, chose to accept the lies of Satan rather than obey the command of God. The Lord God commanded the man, saying, "Of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but you must not eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. For when you eat of it, you will surely die." But Satan beguiled them, saying,
"You will not surely die. For God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil."
Choosing to believe the lie, Adam and Eve ate the forbidden fruit, and their eyes were opened to the horror of their disobedience. Adam and Eve brought sin into the world, and to their shame and dismay, death followed. Since that time, man has continued in his resistance to God. And since that time, man has died a sinner, with his soul condemned to the lake of eternal fire and torment. The same power that created the living cell, that created atoms and the smallest part of matter, also created the stars and the vastness of space. The power is the perfect will of God. It is his workmanship and his plan. And God created man to be a part of his universe, to care for it in God's own image. But we have chosen to care for it in our own image, as sinful pagans full of self-piety and greed. The sin of of our rebellious nature condemns us before the Holy God. The chastisement for our sin is upon us. But God, in His infinite love and mercy, still offers man a choice. That choice is given through the life, death, and resurrection of God's own Son, a sinless, perfect, humble man who is of God and is God. He was with God in the beginning, and through Him all creation was made. He left His heavenly home to come to sinful man and relinquish His life as an atonement for our sin. The perfect sacrificed for the imperfect. Such is the love God has for us and His creation. We no longer have to live in sin and darkness, for we have the gift of forgiveness and light, the gift of eternal life in paradise through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Accept Him and accept God's perfect